In this video, we are going to walk through the installation process for Muncie Power's A20 Series Power Takeoff. This installation took place at Palmer Power Products, and the PTO is being installed on a Kenworth T880 dump truck with an Allison 4500. The first step is to remove the transmission PTO cover plate. Some transmission fluid may escape when the cover is removed. Take care to keep contaminants out of the transmission. Next, open the PTO box and make sure that all needed components are available. Muncie Power offers a complete toolkit that can be ordered separately for easier installation. The toolkit includes all necessary tools to install the power takeoff and can be ordered with or without the torque wrench. If you know the preferred position of the solenoid, you can adjust the orientation before mounting the PTO. Simply loosen the bolts to rotate the valve body. Once positioned, torque all three bolts to 13 foot-pounds. The A20 PTO also features a unique rotatable flange that can be adjusted before or after the PTO installation. To adjust the flange, remove the four cap screws and reposition as needed. Remove the black cover ring to view the stamped position codes. Once in position, reinstall the ring and torque each cap screw to 22 foot-pounds. Next step is to locate the PTO mounting kit and install the two alignment studs in the proper location. See the PTO instructions for guidance on different assemblies and transmission sides. Next, install the Muncie Power installed gasket over the alignment studs. A thin coating of approved transmission fluid may be used to help hold the gasket to the opening. Raise the PTO up to the transmission opening and place the PTO onto the alignment studs. Once in position, hand tighten provided cap screws and washers into all eight locations. For easier access to torque the mounting bolts, the output flange can be easily removed. Simply remove the four bolts and pull off the flange. Next step is to properly torque all eight mounting bolts to 45 foot-pounds. It is recommended to torque the top and bottom cap screws first. It is critical to torque all bolts to the recommended level to ensure proper installation. Our toolkit includes numerous torque wrench attachments, allowing access to all bolt locations. If the flange was removed, or not yet in place, place the seal ring into position and place the flange back on the PTO. Rotate the flange into your required orientation. Your position code can be noted at this time for reference on future installations. Replace the ring and torque all four bolts to 22 foot-pounds. Next, the pump can be mounted. In this installation, we are mounting an E-Series dump pump. All four mounting bolts must be torqued to the proper specifications. It's also important to note that any pump weighing more than 40 pounds is required to have an additional support by a reinforced Z-style bracket. This bracket should be mounted to the back of the transmission and the pump bolt closest to the center of gravity. Once the pump is mounted, the pressure switch and pressure hose fitting can be installed on the valve body. Install the hose to the fitting, and then install the appropriate fitting into the main pressure port and attach the hose. Torque all fittings to 10 to 13 foot-pounds. Next, connect the wire harness to the pressure switch and solenoid valve. This completes the installation of the A20 PTO. Please contact Muncie Power Products for questions or for additional assistance with installation. Installation may vary depending on the chassis and transmission model. Please review provided instructions for more detail.